Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapters 4, 5, and 6. This is a Buhay Farm Library recording. Ephesians, chapter 4. I, therefore, the prisoner in the Lord, beg you to walk worthily of the calling with which you were called, with all lowliness and humility, with patience, bearing with one another in love, being eager to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as you also were called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in us all. But to each one of us the grace was given according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Therefore, he says, when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts to people. Now this he ascended. What is it but that he also first descended into the lower parts of the earth? He who descended is the one who also ascended far above all the heavens, that he might fill all things. He gave some to be apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some shepherds and teachers, for the perfecting of the saints, to the work of serving, to the building up of the body of Christ, until we all attain to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to a full-grown man, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we may no longer be children, tossed back and forth and carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the trickery of men, in craftiness after the wiles of error. But speaking truth in love, we may grow up in all things into him who is the head, Christ, for whom all the body, being fitted and knit together through that which every joint supplies, according to the working in measure of each individual part, makes the body increase to the building up of itself in love. This I say, therefore, and testify in the Lord, that you no longer walk as the rest of the Gentiles also walk, in the futility of their mind, being darkened in their understanding, alienated from the life of God because of the ignorance that is in them, because of the hardening of their hearts. They, having become callous, given themselves up to lust, to work all uncleanness with greediness. But you did not learn Christ that way, if indeed you heard him and were taught in him, even as truth is in Jesus, that you put away, as concerning your former way of life, the old man that grows corrupt after the lusts of deceit, and that you be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and put on the new man, who is in the likeness of God, has been created in righteousness and holiness of truth. Therefore, putting away falsehood, speak truth, each one with his neighbor, for we are members of one another. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your wrath, and do not give place to the devil. Let him who stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, producing with his hands something that is good, that he may have something to give to him who is in need. Let no corrupt speech proceed out of your mouth, but only what is good for building others up as the need may be, that it may give grace to those who hear. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, in whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Let all bitterness, wrath, anger, outcry, and slander be put away from you with all malice. And be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving each other, just as God also in Christ forgave you. Ephesians chapter 5. Be therefore imitators of God as beloved children. Walk in love, even as Christ also loved us and gave himself up for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet-smelling fragrance. But sexual immorality and all uncleanness or covetousness, let it not even be mentioned among you as becomes saints, nor filthiness, nor foolish talking, nor jesting, which are not appropriate, but rather the giving of thanks. Know this for sure, that no sexually immoral person, nor unclean person, nor covetous man who is an idolater has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and God. Let no one deceive you with empty words, for because of these things the wrath of God comes on the children of disobedience. Therefore, do not be partakers with them. For you were once darkness, but are now light in the Lord. Walk as children of light. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth, proving what is well-pleasing to the Lord. Have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather even reprove them. For it is a shame even to speak of the things which are done by them in secret. But all things, when they are reproved, are revealed by the light, for everything that reveals is light. Therefore, he says, "Awake, you who sleep, arise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you." Therefore, watch carefully how you walk, not as unwise, but as wise, redeeming the time because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. Don't be drunken with wine, in which is reckless indignation, but be filled with the Spirit, speaking to one another in psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always concerning all things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to God, even the Father, subjecting yourselves to one another in the fear of Christ. Wives, be subject to your own husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ also is the head of the assembly, being himself the Savior of the body. But as the assembly is subject to Christ, so let the wives also be subject to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the assembly and gave himself up for her, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word, that he might present the assembly to himself gloriously, not having spot nor wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without defect. Even so, husbands also ought to love their own wives as though they were their own bodies. He who loves his own wife loves himself. For no man ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, even as the Lord also does the assembly, because we are members of his body, of his flesh and bones. For this cause a man will leave his father and mother and will be joined to his wife. Then the two will become one flesh. This mystery is great, but I speak concerning Christ and the assembly. Nevertheless, each of you must also love his own wife even as his own self, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. Ephesians chapter 6. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment, with a promise, that it may be well with you and you may live long on the earth. You fathers, do not provoke your children to wrath, but nurture them in the discipline and instruction of the Lord. Servants, be obedient to those who according to the flesh are your masters, with fear and trembling, in singleness of your heart as to Christ, not in the way of service only when eyes are on you as men pleasers, but as servants of Christ, doing the will of God from the heart, with good will doing service as to the Lord himself and not to men, knowing that whatever good thing each one does, he will receive the same good again from the Lord, whether he is bound or free. You masters, do the same things for your servants and give up threatening, knowing that he who is both their master and yours is in heaven, and there is no partiality with him. Finally, be strong in the Lord and the strength of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you might be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our wrestling is not against flesh and blood, but against the principalities, against the powers, against the world's rulers of the darkness of this age, and against the spiritual forces of wickedness in high places. Therefore, put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand therefore, having the utility belt of truth buckled around your waist, and having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and having fitted your feet with the preparation of the good news of peace. Above all, taking up the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the evil one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. With all prayer and requests, praying at all times in the Spirit, and being watchful to this end in all perseverance and requests for all the saints. Pray for me, that utterance may be given to me in opening my mouth, to make known with boldness the mystery of the good news, for which I am an ambassador in chains, that in it I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. But that you also may know my affairs, how I am doing, Tychicus, the beloved brother and faithful servant in the Lord, will make known to you all things. I have sent him to you for this very purpose, that you may know our state and that he may comfort your hearts. Peace be to you, brothers, and love with faith from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace be with all those who love our Lord Jesus Christ with incorruptible love. Amen. End of Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapters 4, 5 and 6. This is a Buhay Farm Library recording. This recording is released under Creative Commons Non-Commercial Use License. Recording by Robert Scott, November 10, 2020.